Have you ever looked at your belly button and wondered why you have one? Why is it there? Where does it come from? Why do they all look different? On today's episode of Think Big Planet, we'll try to help answer these questions and take a quick look at how people come to get their belly buttons. Let's get started. Here we have an expecting mother. Inside of her, a baby is growing and developing. She's a bit thirsty, so she takes a sip of orange juice. Let's see how that drink will make its way to the baby. As the mother digests food and drinks, they get broken down into the nutrients that she needs to be healthy. Since the baby cannot eat or drink on its own, the baby needs something special to get those important nutrients to help the baby grow. This something special is called the umbilical cord. This pathway acts like a highway for the digested nutrients to travel from the mother to the baby. In addition to this, the umbilical cord can also carry the oxygen the mother breathes. Once the baby has used up all that they need, anything that is left over can travel back in the other direction where the mother can get rid of them for the baby. The baby is now old enough and ready to come out of the mother. Now that the baby is out, he or she no longer needs the umbilical cord. Soon after birth, the doctor will first clip each end of the cord, and then snip in between. Once this is done, the remainder of the umbilical cord, including the clip, will stay there until it eventually dries up and falls off, leaving the baby with their belly button. Depending on how it dries, this is how people can have differently shaped belly buttons. Everyone's is a little bit different. Now you might be wondering if all animals have belly buttons. The simple answer to this question is no. Mammals, which includes us humans, all have a form of a belly button, even if it's hiding under fur. For example, a dog. Other animals, such as birds, marsupials, such as kangaroos, reptiles, and even fish do not have one, since they are born differently and have their own unique ways of getting the nutrients they need to develop and grow. We hope you enjoyed finding out the answer to today's question. If there are any other questions you'd like to see answered in future videos, feel free to let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed the video, like, subscribe, click the bell icon to get notifications for our future videos, and we'll see you in the next one.